Hey developers, how's it going? In today's video, we're going to look at 13 ways to vertical center in 2020. Now, back in the day before grid and flexbox and all this really fun stuff, we were kind of limited in what we could do. But in today's video, I want to show you a little bit of this and a little bit of that. Depending on your situation, maybe you're working with flexbox, maybe you're working with some old school stuff, maybe you just want a change of scenery. Whatever reason, I'm going to show you 13 ways. Now, in my code pen, I have examples, and as you can see right now, none of these are really vertically centered, and that's because I've commented the parts that make these things tick. So in today's video, you're also going to get that little bit of interactivity, being able to see how these things work, what makes them tick, and hopefully you can find one or more solutions to your vexing vertical center problem, all right? So let's hop into it. Let's talk about the first technique using absolute positioning and margin auto. Now, if you have an element with no intrinsic size, you can center it by using equal values for the top and bottom. So in our container class, we're going to go position relative, but then in our element class, this is where the magic starts to happen. So we declare position absolute, and then here's an interesting thing we're going to do. Top, bottom, left, and right are all going to be zero, but then we throw in the margin auto. Now the catch is here that we have to explicitly declare the element height. Otherwise, it's going to occupy the entire container. So if I uncomment this, you're going to see something pretty neat happen in about 1 second or so. And as you can see here, that is perfectly centered in this little box here. And if we adjust the size, you can see here, looking pretty good. Number two is the classic top 50%, translate minus 50%. This is an oldie, but a goodie. A lot of us, this is our go-to method for this. It's pretty simple and it relies on absolute positioning of the inner element at 50% from the top of the parent, and then you translate it up 50% of its height. And so in this element class, we have position absolute, top 50%, left 50%, and then we're going to transform that using a translate of minus 50% and minus 50%. And uncommenting that, you can see now it is perfectly centered inside here, looking pretty good, and resizing it. Ooh, looking good. Again, this is a go-to technique for a lot of us, perfectly suited for so many things that you need to center vertically. This next approach is with tables. Now, I know some people are cringing right now. They're saying, oh, using a table in 2020. Hear me out. It's a really simple approach. And this, again, was used a lot back in the day. You don't see it so much nowadays, but you can still use it. And the trick is using the behavior of table cells and vertical align in order to center that element on the container. So up here in our container, we have display table height 100%. And then down at the element, we have display table cell text align center, and then we're going to vertical align it to the middle. One thing to really keep in mind with this technique, though, is that it's going to fail on screen readers, because even if your markup is based on divs, when you set the CSS display to table and table cell, it's going to make the screen reader interpret that as a table. So this could be good for prototyping or something you're keeping in-house just to experiment with, just to give you guys the heads up that this is not accessibility friendly in 2020. Number four is another oldie and a little bit unconventional as well. It's the ghost element method. Now with this one, you're using an inline block with a pseudo element. That's the ghost part of this that has 100% height of the parent. And then you set the vertical align property to the middle. So as you can see here, we have the margin right of -0.25 em, and then down at the element level, we're doing display inline block vertical align to the middle, margin auto width 100%, and then height 50 vh. This one little line is going to make all the difference. As you can see there, it is perfectly centered. The thing that makes this really tick is the pseudo element, or the ghost element, as indicated by these two colons up there. All right, let's enter the modern CSS domain and talk about some flexbox stuff. Now, when flexbox came out, it introduced a pretty cool behavior for auto margins. So it not only horizontally centers the element as it did in block layouts, but it also centers the element in the vertical axis. The catch here is that it only works with a single element, but look at this simplicity. Display up here at the container class, we have display flex, and then down at the element, we have margin auto. So if we uncomment this, I just love the simplicity of this one. And you're dealing, whoopsies, you're dealing with modern CSS. So it's, there's a lot to love about this technique. Look at how nice that looks. And again, this is the margin auto on a flex item using the promise of modern CSS with flexbox. Number six, we're gonna go ghosted again with pseudo elements on a flex container. Honestly, this really isn't the most practical solution, but you can use flexible and empty pseudo elements to push the element to the center. So on the container level, we have before and after, and then just the plain container class right here with margin auto, display flex, and flex direction doing column. And then on the element level, we have margin auto. So let's start here. Whoopsies. Start here and uncomment this, and you can kind of see. Now again, I know this may seem tedious uncommenting this stuff, but I did want to illustrate what these different properties are doing to these elements. So we'll go ahead and uncomment that, uncomment the pseudo element stuff. Boom. Kind of a verbose solution, to be totally honest, but it is a solution, and you may find yourself needing to use something like this within your projects. Just throwing it out there, pseudo elements on a flex container is a perfectly valid solution when you need to vertically center something. All right, developers, we're still flexing on with number 7 and number 8, but let's not get too far ahead of ourselves. Number 7, align on the flex container. So Flexbox introduced some pretty cool alignment properties, and it lets us control how items are placed and how empty space is distributed in some ways that maybe would have required other magic numbers in CSS for like a specific number of elements or some JavaScript hacks. So depending on the flex direction, we could use justify content or align items to adjust, or we could do it on the container. And as you can see here, we have display flex, justify content center, and align items to the center. Those three lines are really what is going to make the magic happen here. And as I uncomment this, look at that. Display flex, again, justify content center, and then align items to the center. There's a lot to love about this technique. It's pretty succinct and easy to implement when you're needing to vertically center. Number 8 is kind of in the same vein, only we're aligning on the flex item. This is a really good one too. Nice terse code here. On the container level, we have display flex, and then down here on the element, we have align self. That's an interesting property here. Align self center, and then margin 0 auto. So let's go ahead and uncomment this first and see what happens. So it's up here centered up top, but now once we fix the container level display flex, it's gonna go right in the middle there. Look at that. Ooh. Now we're gonna get into some grid territory. Number 9 is aligning on the grid container. So just like Flexbox had a line on the flex container or the flex item, we're gonna do the same thing on the grid. We're gonna align on the grid container or the grid item. And this one in particular is the grid container. So as you can see in the element, let's uncomment the element margin 0 auto. And as you can see, once again, up top here it's centered. And here is where our magic happens with the display grid. Align item center and justify content center. This is a nice solution too, using the grid. The grid opens up so many possibilities, and if you're working in that domain and need to vertically center something, this could be a great solution for that. For number 10, we're gonna target a specific grid item because we're aligning on the grid item here. Ooh, I just love this code. Look at how simple this is. Up at the container level, we have display grid, and then down here on the element, we have justify self center and align self-center. Self-centered indeed. So let's go ahead and uncomment that. We have it up top to the left, and now as we display grid, this is gonna look pretty decent. Look at that. Now, the one limitation with using this technique, and the last one I might add, is legacy browser support. So do be mindful of that. But other than that, this is just a great technique to use. Number 11, we're gonna go back into those ghost elements, the pseudo elements on a grid. Because we are using these pseudo elements, this code is a little more verbose. If you haven't used the grid much, these numbers and this unit can get a little tricky. So up here we have display grid, grid template columns, 1FR, grid template rows, and then we're gonna repeat that, and the values are gonna be 3 and then 1FR. Now, 1FR actually means minimax, auto 1FR. So the empty rows are not going to necessarily take 1/3 of the container height. They're going to collapse when they need to, all the way down to their minimal value of auto. And so why would we do this? Well, when you combine FR rows with minimax rows, you're going to have the empty FR rows collapse and then the minimax rows. This is definitely an advanced technique, but it does have its use cases. If we uncomment all this stuff, you can kind of see where we're going with this. Maybe not, because there is so much going on. Once you start adding to this base, you're going to see the magic of what is happening up here with the columns and rows and the minimax and the FR units. This demonstration here is just mostly to show you that it can be done and to show you the syntax. But if you want to see some pretty good implementations of it, definitely do some Googling. Again, this is pseudo elements on a grid. Number 12 is explicit grid row placement. Now, the CSS grid allows us to put items explicitly on a specific row. So just to show you what all we're working with here, we have margin, zero auto. The grid row right here is an important one. We also have an alternate grid row right here. That's just to show you guys, you can use this as an alternative. So up here we have the container display grid, grid template columns 1FR, grid template rows repeat 3 1FR, looking pretty similar to our last example, and then margin auto. And so let's go ahead and uncomment. You can kind of see the magic somewhat working a little bit. There we go. And as we place this on margin auto, what do we get? Okay, we're getting closer. And then for the last one, we're going to see a perfectly vertically centered item there. Look at that, looking good. Finally, number 13, this is a really good one. Margin auto on a grid item. Just like flexbox, if you apply margin auto on a grid item, it's going to center it on both axes. So what we have here is simply on the container display grid, margin auto, whoops, that isn't cool. And then down here on the element, we have margin auto. Look at that. That's a nice clean solution for this. So we're going to go ahead, take that out. Oh, getting closer. Margin auto. Let's uncomment the margin auto and then uncomment this other margin auto. And you're going to see a perfectly centered item right there. Look at that turquoise, looking great. Developers, I hope you enjoyed this video, got some new techniques for vertically centering things. There's something here for everyone for most projects, whether you're doing flexbox stuff, grid stuff, or you're trying out some old school methods. Hopefully you found some use in this video. Thanks for watching. As always, hope you're having a great day, and we will see you in the next video.